Hey everybody, it's Felisa. It's the middle of the flipping night, but I just had an experience that, you know, I wanted to document because admittedly, like, it took me off my square. It's been a long time since I've, you know, felt a certain amount of conflict and, you know, how to handle it and whatever. So, you know, forgive me that I look a hot and complete mess. I ran out to the store and I thought, you know what? This is going to be an entry into AVADIM. This is my car chronicle. You know, it's my video a day in May. Shout out to my May babies and my fellow Tarians. What's up? So, you guys know that I'm very active on social media. So I uploaded, you know, a particular post, and the post was talking about, you know, black-owned businesses and, you know, et cetera, et cetera. There's, you know, a long backstory to that. Anyway, so, you know, someone that I know commented on it, and, you know, we had an exchange back and forth. And at a point in time of our back and forth, I felt that we had a miscommunication. And so because of my nature, I'm like, I don't like things that are like, you know, weird and ambiguous. And so I'm always like, let me make sure that I've come across the right way, you know, that my intent is, you know, appropriately received, that, you know, wasn't something that, you know, I did inadvertently, you know, because I'm always willing to apologize. So, you know, I sent a DM and I got hit with like this person just like went off. Called me rude, said that, you know, they didn't need any advice from me and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what's happening? What's going on right now? And so, like, I'm trying to clarify, and this person was just not having any of it. And, you know, at some point I realized that I just needed to cut my losses. And, you know, truth be told, you know, because I am who I am, and I'm, you know, I'm very sensitive, and I'm very, you know, like, I'm very cognizant of engagement and things like that, at least initially. At some point I'm like, okay, whatever. But, you know, like, I never want to be received the wrong way, especially if that's not my intent. Now, if I intended to be, you know, some rude ass, or, you know, just like full of snark or whatever, like, I'll own to that, like, I'll cop to that, but that was not the intention. So, you know, I'm driving to the store and I'm thinking to myself, what in the world just happened? Like, what happened? Like, I don't know what happened. And I was like, in for a moment I was feeling so badly. Like, I was feeling like, oh my god, like, I literally was like back in high school. And at some point 50-year-old me was like, girl, stop it. Let me tell y'all something. There are some people who are just dedicated to being offended. And no matter what it is that you say, no matter what kind of clarity and what type of context you bring to that situation, they are dedicated to being offended. Why? I have no idea. But they are dedicated to being offended. They are dedicated to not hearing whatever it is that you have to say, because they are dedicated to their own position. Even if that position is wrong, you have got to be able to let that go and let those people go with God. And I'm like, you know what, whatever, because you're wasting your breath and wasting your time trying to bring some levity, or not levity, bring some balance to that situation and make it okay. I have no idea what happened. I have no idea why this played out the way that it did, other than to say, you know, things happen for a reason. They always do. And, you know, whether it's a lesson for me to, you know, kind of put my big girl pants on and not be so, you know, affected and you know, kind of sensitive to everything that everyone says, although I've gotten a lot better as I've gotten older, it still, you know, it affects me. And I'm perfectly willing to say that. Like, I'm not a robot. I'm not somebody that's just like, I'm a huge mush ball. I'm a huge, you know, somebody who takes into consideration people's feelings. And that's one of the reasons why I wanted to DM this person and, like, you know, hey, that wasn't my intent. Like, it feels like you may have taken this the wrong way. And to be hit with like this, like, go offness when I'm trying to, like, you know, make sure that we're good and make sure that we're clear, and that person was not having any of it. So it's not even a matter of the offense for the situation. It was an offense to me for whatever reason, it was an offense to me. And I do take that personally because I feel like, you know what? Maybe this season is up. Maybe this season is not, you know, what I think that it should be. And maybe this is the universe's way of telling me that, you know, this is not a relationship that I need to be in. Now, of course, petty me was like, unfriend her. But, like, what would that, like, what would that prove and what would that solve? Like, that's not, like, I don't feel the need to do that. I really don't. I don't feel the need to go that far because now I'm matching petty with petty. Even though, like, I felt like this was, like, completely out the blue and that was not my intention. You know, it is what it is. And, you know, I just have gone on with my life and it just has to be that way. So, I'm telling y'all, listen to me. Don't waste your breath explaining yourself over and over to people who are dedicated to the art of misunderstanding and dedicated to the art of offense. Once you have put out, you know, your apology, your mea culpa, your, you know, your, let me make sure that we're good, make sure that we're clear on this, and someone is still deciding in that moment that they don't give an flying F about whatever it is that you're saying, that they are going to pursue this offense, this imaginary offense over here because that makes a better scenario for them. It makes a better narrative for them to react to something that isn't even real. Then you gracefully bow out of that game because it's not something that you can win. You can't win against somebody's perception. Perception is 99-100% of anything. Whatever it is that someone thinks that you did, whatever it is that someone thinks that you are, whatever it is that someone thinks that you're about, that's what it is. Period. Point blank. No equivocations. No deviations. So when you're up against someone's perspective and their thought process as it pertains to you or whatever it is that you did, it's a losing battle. Put what you can out there, let the universe take care of the rest. You go on about your business, and that's the lesson for me and hopefully the lesson for you, because otherwise you'll just continue to spin your wheels and you'll continue to feel like shit, quite frankly, because you keep chasing somebody trying to ask for forgiveness for something that you never did. Like, how does that work? Anyway, I'm Felisa. I hope that you guys are enjoying your night. I'm about to go into the house, finish enjoying. It's 10:32. Cinco de Mayo. And I will talk to y'all later on. Bye.